out all day just shopping, getting some stuff that I needed. My mom's supposed to be doing my hair tomorrow, so I got some like braiding hair, edge control, things like that. But y'all, while I come home, and it is like so many dishes in the sink. My mom ain't clean none of her mess up that she was supposed to clean up. So now I'm expected to clean it up. One thing I'm gonna love about getting my own apartment soon is not have to clean up after anybody but myself, because, but I'm supposed to leave it all night. I guess the fuck not, but I just wanna show you some of the stuff that I got. I went to Trader Joe's too. I ain't been to Trader Joe's in a minute. So I was like, let me go to Trader Joe's. I was supposed to get the, the piece of dough that you can like roll out yourself, but they didn't have any more. So I got a ready made one. I'm definitely gonna do piece it tonight. I'm gonna show you how I make that. I'm gonna do it with pesto. I love pesto. Pesto, grilled chicken, turkey pepperoni, some zucchini squash, and then I'm going to do the broccoli and kale salad from Trader Joe's on the side, because I had it this weekend and it was... So yeah, I'm gonna definitely need a glass of wine because I gotta clean, do all this stuff. But yeah, show y'all everything I got. We always run out of like hand soap because we like washing our hands in this house. So I got a big ass bottle of the antibacterial hand soap. This one is really, really good. Some more scrub. I got this brand, the one from Walmart. This one eats every time. Like, you really can't beat it. Y'all, so usually in my house, we use tea lights and candle warmers. That's how we like to heat up the house. And everybody always says our house smells good, so it's never no issue. But they didn't have any more at Walmart, so I got this candle. Y'all, when I tell you it's giving mahogany teakwood, and I'm a mahogany teakwood girl. And I just bought a new candle lighter too, so this is going up to be gutting out my entire room. I'm gonna be throwing away stuff. I'm gonna be switching my summer to winter wardrobe. I'm gonna show y'all some of the new things I purchased for my winter wardrobe. And it's just gonna be a nice, cute little chill video. But that scent right there, yummy. What else did I get? Some more toner. The Thayers, I think that's how you pronounce it. Where the fuck is this? What the fuck? There's this one. What else did I get? I was at my bestie's house this past weekend, and she had the vanilla and cashmere one, but obviously the girls on TikTok sold the shit out, so I got this one. But so what we're gonna do is mix these two together, then add my Dolce & Gabbana light blue, and the smell is just gonna because these are all cleaner scents, and I like to smell like I just did laundry. Like I said, some stuff from the hair store, some new clips. Also, let me put y'all on, because one of my good friends that I've known for years put me onto this a couple years ago. It is the Wild Growth Hair Oil. And if you know, you know. Some more bubbles. Since I'm about to get my hair braided, I need like the large rubber bands. Then I got a new claw clip. Oh, and also, y'all, this right here, I use to... as eyebrow gel as well, and it works beautifully. I've gotten so many compliments on it, and I use it for my edges. So 10 out of 10, and I think what? $1.99. Like literally $1.99. You can't beat that. So yeah, that's all of that. And then I have a whole nother bag of goodies. Like I told you, I was outside all freaking day. What's happening? Like I said this before, if my husband don't got any money, like it's really gonna be hard for us to really be together, because I like to go shopping. Of course I'm gonna have my own money, but I want his money too. And then I got a whole bunch of braiding here, y'all can see. So we got to be cute. My mom, just when I tell y'all how lucky I am to have a parent who knows how to do hair and who is licensed in how to do hair, she do it every time for me. So I'm gonna get some 30-inch knotless with the curly ends. And then what else we got? Stop at a dollar store. I'm gonna try a new recipe with my oats. So I bought some more of these from the dollar store. Got some more plastic bags. Love a good plastic bag. My camera just decided to turn off. Like, the fuck is wrong with you? So yeah, I wanted to try this oat creamer Kayla cake on YouTube, IG, TikTok. She's been talking about this, and I wanted to add this in my overnight oats because I love brown sugar oatmeal, so I was like, add this plus like my regular recipe, see what it do as a replacement for the almond milk. some more nanners, because y'all know I love bananas. Some more garlic. I use garlic in everything I cook. And then my family loves the Trader Joe's hash browns. They say it's just like the McDonald's ones. So I got 2 packs of those. Yeah, they love these fucking hash browns. They are to me, but they love them. I'd rather have like cut up potatoes and hash browns, in my opinion. And that's pretty much it, y'all. That is the completion of my haul. I'm gonna show y'all later on how I make my pizza and how I make my overnight oats. But other, and let's talk about the skin. Let's talk about the skin. Y'all see this? Like, we're maintaining just luxury over here, okay? But yeah, I'll see you when I come back on paper. So yeah, just been away some of these dishes because, like I said, people just don't like to clean up after themselves. Like, I can't stand it. Let me push y'all back a little bit because that looks crazy. Push y'all back a little bit. This looks absolutely crazy. So I just smelled the creamer. It does smell good. It does definitely smell like brown sugar, but it smells very, very sweet and very strong. So I'm just gonna do one of the oats with the brown sugar, taste it tomorrow, see what it's giving, and then if, you know, it tastes good, then I'll do the other one. If not, then, you know, lesson learned, and we'll just stick with almond milk. But it smells very strong, so I'm gonna let y'all know how that goes. Yeah. So I'm already running like late as per usual. We said we're gonna work on time management, but not this week. So I have on my go-to Primark button-up blazer. It's not a blazer, it's like a button-up. Super, super, super cute. Have on, as well as one of my go-to pieces, my crop top ribbed, my ribbed crop top from Forever 21. And then I have on my Forever 21 cozy sweatpants. And then I have on my Vans. When I took them out of the box, y'all, I usually keep my sneakers in the box, because I'm really good about having my sneakers clean. And y'all, I've had these sneakers for like 2 years, and they looked brand new when I took them out of the box. That's how you know I don't really wear sneakers. So I'm definitely gonna try to get back into that bag. And then I have my errand bag that I have from Target. Had this for a while too. And let's hurry up, because I already gotta call the people and be like, yo, I'm running late, y'all. So I literally just came from getting my wax appointment with my girl Shatori. Y'all, why she just tell me she moving in February? Like, I can't never hold a wax girl. My last wax girl up and left. Now Shatori saying she leaving. I'm just like, I can't. But yes, your girl is feeling tight, clean, and fresh. And if y'all not, I've seen on TikTok, the girlies have been not showering before they wax. Someone is inside your vagina. Literally, like it's a gyno appointment. Why are you not waxing? I mean, why are you not showering before you go get a wax? Like, let it sit in. Let it sit in. Because it's not making sense to me. It's not. Let's get it together, ladies. Let's get it together. But for ladies who are washing before they get their wax, I'm proud of y'all. We got to stand strong. Stand together. But yeah, I'm about to head over to Walmart. This is what my wallet says. Treat yourself. And you only get one of these lives. So I'm going to treat myself. So yeah, I'm just going to pick up some bins and like one or two ottomans. I don't know if I mentioned to y'all in the last video that I'm really trying to move forward to a minimalistic lifestyle. And one part of that minimalistic lifestyle is me just rearranging and gutting out all the stuff that I don't need in my room. So I'm just going to be getting some storage bins, a couple things we need for the house, and then going the fuck home. I'm really craving pasta, so I'm going to make some pasta tonight and then, you know, make a little leftover for work tomorrow because I have work. But yeah, that's about it. So yeah. Don't forget, keep it tight, clean, and fresh. All right, y'all. So I somehow end up in Five Below. It's right next to the Walmart. So I just picked up like 2 things, like I said, to organize my room and just make it as minimalistic as possible. I don't even think I honestly will need to go to Walmart now that I have what I need.
I can't say that my sneakers look brand new if I'm not gonna show y'all. So these are my platform Vans. Like I said, I've had them for 2 years. Like, do y'all see? These things look brand freaking new. Like, I really keep my sneakers in good condition.
So y'all, I was just talking to Instagram about this, but like, I feel like it needs to be addressed. Like, the customer service just has not been hitting for me these last couple days. I went to two stores in the last 2 days, and like, just nobody giving me what it's supposed to give. Go to Best Buy yesterday to pay my bill. I'm asking the guy about, you know, photography cameras because I want to start taking like photos on my camera instead of my phone. He's like, look on YouTube. Sir, do you not work at Best Buy? You don't have any type of recommendations? He's like, oh, Sony. No, he didn't say a Sony, a Canon. Is there a specific lens? A 50 millimeter, a 50. Bro, you ain't got nothing for me. Like, his attitude was just not there. His energy was not there. And I understand you're at work. I have to work too, just like a regular person. But, like, just, ugh. Then today I go to T-Mobile, try to see if I can get a new phone. I'm sitting in there 10 minutes, y'all. Nobody says anything to me. This man is on his phone playing Candy Crush or whatever the fuck he was playing. Nothing. No, give me a second, ma'am. Blase, nothing. Like, I'm gonna need y'all to get it together. Get it together, like, now, please. But I understand people be having long days. Like, I work 12-hour shifts. Like, I understand. But, like, still, like, come on, y'all. Come on. Act like you want to help me at least. Shit. You getting paid for it? Come on.
All right, y'all. So, your girl is back. The lighting is trash. Let me open the windows a little bit. I told y'all I have to buy a new light for my camera. That is on the way. But I'm just gonna be basically doing a deep cleaning. It's time for me to switch my summer clothes to my winter clothes. Obviously, I still haven't done it. But yeah, that's what we're gonna do today. And it's between today, tomorrow, and Monday. Today is Saturday. We're gonna start with my big closet first. I have two. Basically, I'm just going to be getting rid of any shoes that don't fit, any clothes that don't fit, and just basically making space for newness. As I'm, you know, doing this reset and this deep clean, I'm watching my girl Monet, and she's also doing her reset as well. This has been on my mind for a while. I've been saying that I wanted to live more of a minimalistic lifestyle and only the things I need. So I'm just getting rid of stuff that just has no purpose and holds no space in my life anymore to make space for new. So like I said, I'm gonna start with my big closet, then do my little closet, and then we're gonna do my room, like my actual room. I'm gonna be throwing away a lot of stuff, a lot of appliances, and I also purchased some stuff from the dollar store, Five Below, and Walmart, just to hold more space. So yeah, we gonna get into it. And let's look at the body. Like, mind you, I have my period, so I don't even know what my body's bodying like this, but here we are. And y'all, Thanksgiving was the other day, and when I tell you I got one of the best compliments ever by my aunt, she was like, girl, you look so good. And I was like, stop, because I definitely gained weight. And she was like, you even got a little booty. And y'all, I ain't never had no booty in my life. So that compliment she gave me, coming from a woman with a lot of yash, like, I'm feeling Gucci now. But yeah, let's get into it. We have my room. Like, I'm changing this space all around, y'all. It's gonna be a whole different vibe when y'all see this. Like, I am so excited. Yeah, I am so excited. It's gonna be a whole brand new vibe next time y'all see this room. So stay tuned. Y'all already know I gotta take a little small break. It gets me riled up. Y'all see the closet? Like, I'm embarrassed. Like, why does it look like that? Like, also another reason why I'm preparing and moving this out and giving space for the new is because in the next couple months, like, I'm trying to be more intentional with my words and hold some things to myself and not really jot things out until they're prepared. But I'm planning to be in a new environment, a new space, and I want to make room for that. I don't want to have to take too much with me, and all this stuff I've had with me since college. college. I've been home since I graduated, and I'm just ready for newness. So we gotta make space. Like, and let me know in the comments, are y'all sativa girls or are y'all indica girls? I'm definitely a sativa girl. I'd rather have indica when I like go to sleep, but like sativa all day. I wanna be lit. And once I really start cleaning, I'm gonna probably either put on YouTube or put on some music and get it popping. Sun is going down, so you know y'all not gonna be able to get this natural lighting, so I'm definitely gonna put on my studio light, but if it gets too bad, I'm just gonna wait till tomorrow. So yeah, let me eat a little something, get myself fueled, and then we're gonna get into it.
Is there any room for me? I won't have to hold my breath till you get down on my knees, cause you're on it.
So y'all, so basically, I took all the stuff out of my little drawer that I have in there. In that drawer, I usually keep like my sweatpants, my pajama shirts, shorts, things like that. So now I'm just separating the stuff that I want to keep for the fall and the stuff that I'm putting in bins from the summertime. And then I'm going to separate them between things that I'm throwing away and things that I'm keeping. These I've had for years. They're going away. These I'm keep. These are pretty sturdy. These, they don't fit right on me, but I'm gonna keep them because I know good and well they'll be able to fit. Get rid of them. I'm gonna keep these. Mind you, y'all, I've had these Nike like little tight shorts for forever. I can't wait till the booty start bootying so they can, you know, look the way they need to look. Keeping those. This, I'll keep these. I'll keep these. Keep these. Keep these. Keep these. And we'll keep that. So first pile done. Definitely want to wear this sometime again during the winter and like remake it into a different fit. So I'm gonna put that in this pile for my little winter collection. This one, I keep trying to rewear this dress and get pics in it, but like it's just not working. I don't know what's going on. So I'm gonna give it for right now. I'm gonna put it in the summer bin just for next year. It's not a summer outfit, but just put it in the next year pile. See if something comes to me. What else is in here? Just my like robes and stuff, so I'll keep that in the closet. This is a summer dress, so we're gonna put that in the summer bin. This is like a little winter thing that Tiff got us a couple years ago, matching sets, so I'm gonna put that, leave that in there. This is, I feel like this is more of a summer lounge type of set. So I think I'm gonna put this in the summer pile. I don't think this is a winter type set. So I'm putting it in the summer pile. Yeah, this is my go-to, so we keep that in there. Keep this in there. Keep the. I'm actually gonna get rid of this jacket. I just can't figure out what to wear with this, so I'm just gonna let that go. This is also too big. I'm gonna let this go too. Like I said, y'all. It's some stuff I have in my closet that still has tags on it from years ago. Like, why am I holding some of this stuff on it? When we get to the shoes and we start organizing and getting rid of those, like, that's when we're really gonna get busy because shoes are a whole nother vibe. This is summer, get rid of that. I'm sorry, I didn't get rid of that. I put that in the, put it in the summer clothes. Pile this and get rid of that. Like the stuff here. I thought I bought this shirt from Hot Topic. My sister liked shopping there. I saw this and I was like, so fire. So I only wore this once in the summertime.
So I think I'm gonna keep this as a summer shirt and put it away in my summer clothes. But this is so cute. I like the patterns. If I see the patterns on it, it's so freaking cute. I really like this old shirt, so I'll put that away. Nice. I really like this shirt. Put it away for sometime next summer. I wore this on the gram already, but definitely gonna revamp this next summer. Figure out what to do with that. This one is Waff. Already, like, you know, made this shirt into different styles several times, so I really, really like this shirt. I got it from Target. So I am currently at Butcher 360, which is a Korean barbecue place. My sister said she wanted to go. Her birthday was last week, so I was like, all right, might as well go. I've been here once before, but it was a while ago. So yeah, let me show y'all what everything looks like.